Okay, good afternoon, folks, and welcome to the 44th meeting of the 13th elected Town Council of the Town Council of Happy, our Town Council meeting of the Town of Happy Valley Goose Bay. And this evening is an emergent meeting, and it's been advertised as such, with a single item to be discussed. So before we start, as our CAO is away from town on leave, we need to appoint a town clerk. So I will normally pass the chair to the director, or the chair of finance, I mean, but she's unable to attend today. So I will pass, can I pass it to you, sir, to appoint the town clerk?
Okay.
Would you have any experience in that?
Oh, yes.
All right, so I'll pass the floor to Councilor Brumfield to appoint our town clerk.
Thank you, Your Worship. For this meeting, where the CAO is not here, is on annual leave holidays, I would like to appoint our administrative assistant, Kathy, as our town clerk.
Okay, so it's been moved by Councilor Brumfield that we appoint our executive assistant, Kathy Blake, to Kathy Blake. That's a wow. There you go, Kathy Eddy. That's a slip back. Kathy Eddy as our town clerk. So it's been moved by Councilor Brumfield, seconded by Councilor Compton Hobbs. Discussion? None heard. All those in favor indicate with aye.
Aye.
Aye. Contrary minded? Passed. Okay, so we've appointed town clerk. So that's our legality out of the way. We move into the adoption of the agenda for the 44th meeting, and I'd accept a motion to adopt the agenda as it's presented. Moved by Deputy Mayor Wallace, seconded by Councillor Winters. Discussion? Okay, all those in favor indicate with aye.
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 Contrary minded? Passed. All right, so we have single item agenda, and I'm going to pass the floor over.
A point of order,
okay,
Your Worship.
Point of order.
In this case, with regards to the development regulations amendments, I will declare myself in a conflict of interest.
Okay, so please have the minutes indicate that Councillor Pomeroy has indicated that he's leaving the meeting and sitting in the gallery as a conflict.
I'll declare myself in conflict as chair of the Housing and Homelessness Coalition as well.
Okay, and also have the minutes indicate that Councillor Compton Hobbs is also declaring conflict for her association with the Housing Coalition, Housing and Homelessness Coalition. And if the minutes would indicate such, and she'll also be sitting in the gallery. All right, so I will pass the, as this is a Community Planning and Development Committee issue, I'll pass the chair to, I'll pass the floor over to the chair, Councillor Brumfield. Floor is yours, sir.
Okay, thank you, Your Worship. The Community Planning and Development Committee recommends that the proposed resolution that an amendment to the Municipal Planning and Development Regulations 2018 to 2028 is undertaken for the following changes. That on the commercial use zone table, the following uses will be changed from permitted use to discretionary uses, and that is emergency shelter and hostel. That on the public institutional use zone table, the following uses will be changed from permitted uses to discretionary uses. Assisted living, nonprofit housing, supportive housing, emergency shelter, transitional housing, and hostel. That on the rural use zone table, the following uses will be changed from permitted uses to discretionary uses, and that is emergency shelter.
Okay, it's been moved that by Community Planning and Development, the following amendments be made to the noted amendments be made to our Municipal Plan and Development Regulations 2018 to 2028 with the noted changes. Do I need to read the changes again from a motion perspective? You got them. Okay. Seconded by Deputy Mayor Wallace. Discussion? Okay, so I think what we've done, or what we're proposing to do with this change to the development regulations and the municipal plan is to just tighten up things that maybe I guess within our plan, so that council, given the complexities of these types of facilities, that council remains in full know, and that each case would trigger a a use of discretionary power from council, which would constitute us having to bring in a public consultative process and that kinds of stuff. So that's what we're suggesting here today. Any other discussion? Councilor Brumfield.
Yes, I'd like to point out too that in all the changes we're making for the emergency shelter and the hostel and so forth, these are just changes to the permitted uses and to discretionary uses. All the definitions are still the exact same in our regulations.
And it also, it doesn't preclude us from doing any of these type of facilities. It's just that the approval would require the discretionary use of council. It's not that we are not doing things. It's just that the way that things will be done will include a guarantee now, a community involvement process into what we're what would come to us and come to a table. Any further discussion? Okay, none. Okay, all those in favor indicate with aye.
Aye.
Contrary minded? Motion is passed. So, as again, an emergent meeting. We only have the single agenda item. No delegations that present to us, and as well, no further agenda items. So, with that, I will accept a motion to adjourn. Moved by Deputy Mayor Wallace, seconded by Councillor Winters. All those in favor indicate with aye.
Aye.
Aye. Contrary minded? Meeting is adjourned.